What is up, you guys? It's your boy Jason, and welcome back to MyGlamm. Today, I have someone really special with me. Ta-da! Ayesha, everybody, aka Alina.
Hi, guys.
It's really early for both of us to be right in front of y'all. That's why I look like a waste, and she looks like
bonkers. You look like
person.
You've already done makeup.
I wanna be beautiful.
I wanna be pretty.
I'm gonna learn something from her, and
hardly, let's be honest.
People like me need makeup because this face is a pimple.
There's something growing out of your neck.
A pimple.
Oh no, it's your head.
But today, today we're gonna just have a lot of fun with makeup. So grab your makeup, grab your teeth. That's all you need to grab. And get ready with us. Are you excited?
I am so excited. I can't wait to just watch you and copy and like learn stuff.
What do you do first when you start doing your makeup?
So I already washed my face and I put like a moisturizer with SPF already. Mm. And I haven't washed my face after that. So I'm just going to start straight up with my base. Okay, I'm just going to like do what I actually do at home. And if I'm doing something colossally wrong or if you have something to teach me, please butt in.
Okay.
He's already started, hasn't he?
Yeah.
I already messed up.
So what's your concern with your face?
The biggest problem, man, that I have is my dark circles. There's literally no cure for this except a good night's rest. But when you're on camera and the lights are going to be in a certain way, these shadows become very pronounced. So the first thing I need to take care of is my under eye.
So for that, I have a solution for you. Basically, MyGlamm has this Total Makeover FF Cream Palette.
Ooh.
And they have like correctors and the foundation concealer and one is like a 5-in-1 product that comes in a compact. And the orange and the red correctors work really well. So you should definitely try like the orange and the red corrector under your eyes first.
Okay. Okay, wait. So you're actually using that for what?
No, I'm just using the foundation directly.
You're not doing this?
No, because then I just cake my face.
That kind of looks like what I'm doing. Because, I mean, I feel like whenever I use brushes, I don't feel like I'm in control. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
This feels more like finger painting, which makes me feel like I can really get into those creases. See, look, wow, this already looks a lot better. Like I actually got 8 hours of sleep.
I mean, right now I'm sure like you have like orange cast on your face. So now you need to put like, yeah, you do. Now you need to put concealer on top of it.
Oh, then it looked like I have 12 hours of sleep.
Yes.
Nice, okay.
So Alina and I know each other for about 3 years now. It was amazing because when we met, we figured I just met my soulmate.
Man, I actually felt like I knew you for a lot longer.
I know, right?
And even now, whenever I bump into you at some place, I just automatically feel like it's going to be a good night. It's good. Yeah, because we almost always never meet when the sun's out. This is like the first time we're meeting in the day.
Yeah, that's so true. That's
in
actually
3 years.
True. So how many hours, minutes, seconds do you invest when you're doing your makeup? Besides when a makeup artist is doing your makeup on camera?
When I'm doing my own makeup, it literally depends on how much time I have. I can do it in 5 minutes, I can do it in 2 hours.
Wow.
I have a lot of fun doing makeup because it feels like painting to me. I don't know the nuances, but I love trying new stuff. I just love it. And I really like going extra because if I'm going to put so much time and effort onto my face, I might as well look like I've put time and effort on my face.
Absolutely.
It's got to be the weirdest part of my makeup. Look at me.
Define beauty. What do you think beauty is, according to you? I mean, it's such a conversation in the beauty community these days.
I know.
What beauty should be.
Confidence. Okay. Genuinely. What I find attractive in somebody, more than how they look, is how they carry it off, right? Which is why there's so many different styles that even you try, man. There's so many different styles that like you can look completely different in the same day, but you carry them off with equal panache. And I think that's what makes it beautiful. Because I see so many women just like doing lots of, you know, trendy things and all that shit, but I don't believe in trends. Let me just put it that way.
Yeah, me neither. I don't believe in trends. Yeah, so I wanted to know, when did you start, like, do you think like when you started working in the industry, that's when you were forced to wear makeup or you got into it, or you always had passion and love for makeup?
College. College is when I started really experimenting.
And do you think it was because of peer pressure? Was it from boys?
No, it was because I wanted to look like Lady Gaga.
Oh my god, I think that's exactly what I said. I feel like everybody has had, like, you know, everybody has gone through a Gaga phase. in their life.
Whether they admit it or not.
Yeah, like, everyone.
I agree.
Everyone. Do you ever carve your brows?
What? What does that mean?
So you take like a little bit of concealer and then you like...
Yes.
Yeah. I love
it. I did it right in the beginning. Yeah, it makes them really like visible. Also today I want like a powerful and dependable look, so I'm doing my eyebrows even more because I just feel like they make me look very sorted. What's your favorite memory of me?
Oh, the first that we met, it was her birthday. Long story cut short, you basically like come in and you said, "You look cute." And then I was like, "Oh, she likes me." But back then I had no idea about, I'm sure you had no idea who I was, and we just knew we were fancy.
You know when you just vibe with someone,
yeah,
you're know. Like, that person in the room,
yeah.
We could be friends.
Mm-hmm. I know what you're up to.
We sound so judgy right now.
We do?
Yeah, I mean, because how can you just tell by looking at someone? But you can, man.
You can.
Maybe not through a screen, but if you meet someone, like their energy, yeah. Like you can just tell if they're happy or if they're like low
the
or
word.
If they're...
Also shoes. You're wearing great shoes. I'm sorry, but like if you have good pair of shoes, I know you're a nice person.
Wow.
Yeah, that's
words of wisdom.
Mm-hmm. I'm telling you, shoes. This one advice I always tell people: put your makeup on point and your shoes on point. Everything could be trashy, you will still look good. Are you using your fingers for your eyeshadows?
Yeah. Is that?
Wow. That's just amazing. The table of the beauty community is shaken.
I'm just saying, man, like, I mean, for poor people like me, this helps.
Do you have, like, relationship goals in life? Do you dress up in a certain way when you start dating?
No, man, it's actually the opposite for me. When I start dating, then I don't care. Then I'm just like, this is it. Take it or leave it. But when I'm into someone, actually, it's been a while since I've, like, had a crush. I think mascara is magic.
That is true. Oh, I just put that. You're trying this. Oh, yeah. Let's put some mascara.
Can I try it?
Yeah, you should. Threesome mascara.
Okay, here we go.
So good.
Oh, wow.
Just gonna use pop lights on my cheekbones.
How do you use that?
Let me do it for you. Come here. Give me a beauty blender. So, I'm gonna use this side of it.
Oh, that high up?
Yeah, because it's gonna make a C, so the light catches all the way here, even a little bit on your brow bone.
You went all the way here, right? Oh my god, this is magic.
You make a C, yeah. So these are the lipsticks that I was actually talking about.
Mm-hmm.
These are the creme liquid matte creamy buttlicious lipsticks.
They're How can you be creamy and matte?
They're creamy and matte. But they don't like dry off your lip or look chunky.
That's the problem that I have with those matte like...
Yeah, most like, of the liquid lipsticks.
Yeah.
Yeah, but this is like the right amount of liquid and the right amount of cream, right amount of matte, and it's just all of it.
Oh my god, I'm so happy someone came up with the solution to this.
So these are like the four colors. We have like rosé, we have runway, which is like more neon pink side, rosé is nude, and then you have this... I'm sure I've been flaunting this color everywhere.
I saw that on your Instagram, yeah.
Yeah, it's just, this is possessed. I'm obsessed with possessed. And then you have high voltage. So what do you feel like?
I'm gonna go with rosé.
Rosé? Like
yeah.
Cool.
Yes. I think it's like a dependable look.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna just go with runway.
Oh, you're right, I don't feel any of that dryness.
Yeah, I've just added a little more concealer because I want it to be a little more pale. Yeah, it looks cute.
It looks amazing. It's really complimenting this.
Yeah, it's really complimenting this.
Yeah.
Do you want to give any one last message to our beauty lovers out there?
I just hope watching me has given you guys some hope because it doesn't mean that you have to be a pro. You'll always have friends like Jason to help you out. And try new stuff, experiment, and mascara is magic.
So if you like this video and if you loved watching us, which I'm sure you did, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up.
And you must subscribe to this channel because there's always something exciting happening here. So hit that bell icon because you should know what's up. It's time for us to get out?
Yes.
All right.